I'm here with a new Thunderfly tarp. It came with panel poles, and the thing about panel poles is they need to be seam sealed before they're watertight. You want to make sure you test your seam sealing job before you go out in the woods and you're depending on it. To test these, I put it out in a rain overnight. You want to make sure you've got a good several hours soak on here to be sure it really is watertight. Under current conditions, it's cold, and it's hard to tell if this is wet or just cold when I touch it. To make 100% sure, I have a little trick. I like to take a tissue, and then you just blot it really firmly up against there. If there's any moisture in there at all, it'll show up on the tissue. Now in this case, it's completely dry, which is good. I use a separate tissue for each of the panel poles and other areas that I wanted to seam seal. Oh, one other thing. Use the tissues that don't have lotion. Some tissues come with lotion in them now to make them nice and soft on your nose. You want the ones that are just plain, cheap old tissues. It'll soak up every drop of water. So I've seen some people struggling with the panel poles and the pole mod. Their first thought is to just wrap the line or the shock cord they have on the panel pole around the pole tip, and it just pops out. If you just wrap this line around, it obviously pops off. Even if you put it in with a half hitch or another hitch, if you don't keep tension on it, it pops off. So I have a solution for that. It has to do with how I tie the knot to make the loop. I don't have to keep tension on that at all. Do the same thing here, it's in. So how do I do that? I've tied the loop with two knots, two overhand knots, so they slide. I open it up, stick the pole tip in between those two knots, then tighten it down. You get it good and tight, that'll actually pull the pole tip out of the poles before it falls out. Now with that in there, I can very easily just walk around the tarp, fix it in on the other side, and I don't have to worry about it falling out. And I don't have to worry about that popping out in a wind. Let me show you how to make this loop that I put on my panel pole. All right, so we'll take a look at that with two different colored lines. They just represent opposite ends of your loop. Cross the ends of your loop. Take one end, say the orange one, goes around the back of the white one. Bring it back up over the front. There's a little gap there. Push it around the back and through the gap. Boom, one overhand knot. The white line goes up, hold them next to each other, down behind both lines, and then back up through the loop. Now you have two overhand knots that act like stoppers on these lines that are sliding past each other.
If you're going to be in a strong wind and you're worried that you're in loose soils that won't hold your stakes very well, and you don't have a good tree root behind which to anchor a stake, and you don't have a conveniently located tree to tie off to, one of the things you can do is daisy chain a few stakes together. So put your first stake in and take a line, wrap it around either down here at the stake or up just above it, run it back to another stake. If you need to, take a third stake. I think I learned this canoe camping in 4-H.
Hey, so I'm out in the snow underneath my 13-foot Superfly. I'm putting the pole mod in. One of the things with the pole mod is this little pocket can be very stiff. It can be hard to get the tip of the pole into the pocket. I'll use a little stick very carefully so I don't poke a hole through my tarp to kind of poke that pocket open, pick it open, and slide that pole tip in there.